أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، الصادق الوعد الأمين. Dear brothers, sisters, welcome back to our family night daily every Friday. May Allah عز وجل accept our salah, accept our good deeds, inshallah. Our lecture or topic tonight, it's very important for every and each Muslim around the globe. Why? Because we are all facing too many problems as Muslims in our communities, in our families, in general, our countries. This is what Islam named it, and they said what we should do during the fitna time, during the trials and affliction, temptation, killing, confusion, what a Muslim should do. Of course, we have to know, because Allah Azza wa Jal already instructed us and our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also he did. We have too many fitnas nowadays. Fitnat al-shubuhat wa fitnat al-shahawat. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about Bani Israel, he said, وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانُوا بِآيَتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ. Our scholars, they said, لَا تُنَالَ الْإِمَامَ فِي الدِّينِ إِلَّا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالْيَقِينِ. Means, if you want to be imam, leader, among your people, among your community, you have to be certain about the message of Allah. You have to be certain about the hereafter. You have to have certainty, 100%, about Allah, His messengers, His deen, very important. And also, try as much as you can to be away from any kind of doubt, they name it or they call it gray area. That doubt, وَلَعَزُ بِاللَّهِ, or following your desires. If you stop following your desires, if you are certain, you have certainty, Allah Azza wa Jal will give you the imama fi al-deen. You will be imam in your deen. You will be leader in your deen. You will be among the people which they call them, Allah named them in the Quran, Surah Al-Waqi'ah, the foremost people, as-sabiqoon, inshaAllah. Like Sahaba, Uthman ibn Affan, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, Sa'd ibn Abu Waqqas, Umar ibn Abdullah ibn Umar. These Sahaba, they faced too many fitan like us, but they passed it with their patience, with their certainty about Allah and His deen. You see this fitan of al-firq wal-madhahib. What is al-firq wal-madhahib? Too many sects, too many groups now in Islam. These groups and these sects, like exactly, you have a tree, and that tree, mashallah, has too many branches and a beautiful tree. Suddenly somebody get the saw or scissor and they start cutting these branches. Somehow it will not be tree anymore. If you make Islam like branches and mazahib, too many sects like that, subhanAllah, too many differences, too many fear between Muslims, big gaps between Muslims can happen. That's why you have to understand this. Also, the fitan which is we are facing nowadays, fitnat al-dunya wa hubb al-mal, the love of wealth and love of dunya. This is what Rasulullah said, Allah destroyed Bani Israel because of these two fitnas, women, dunya, and money. They used to love this so much. If we come to this point, we'll be in big trouble too. And one of the worst of these fitna nowadays, the fitna of al-harj. What is al-harj? قتل. What is القتل? Killing everywhere. Killing everywhere. سبحان الله. Today I read in the news like after Saturday Jum'ah in New York, one of the hospitals, somebody was shooting. These people, they are sick. They are going to asking for cure and you're going to kill them in the hospital. What is this? Who's that person? We don't know. Why he's killing them? We don't know. Why they've been killed for, without any reason? We don't know. This is what Rasulullah is saying. Look overseas. See what happened to the Muslim people. Iraq, Syria, Sham, Palestine before, in Egypt, in Libya, Burma, in Afghanistan. If you look around the Muslim Ummah, around the world, you see Muslim killing Muslim or Muslim being killed by others. What is this? This is confusion. This is ikhtilat. This is qatl, harj. Rasulullah said that. Even لا يدري القاتل لما قتل والمقتول لما قتل. Rasulullah said that. القاتل, the killer. If you ask him why you kill these people, he don't know. He get order. That's it. He's doing the order. And the one who been killed, why they killed you? وإذا الموؤودة سئلت بأي ذنب قتلت. Why you been killed? I don't know. They killed me. I was just sleeping. I found myself in the grave. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. This is fitna. Rasulullah said that. And the worst of this fitna also, استباحة المحرمات. استباحة المحرمات means people, they make haram, they give fatwas, and they make it halal. يصيغوا خلاص. Sheikh said, the Imam said, the Mufti said. Said what? Haram, you make it halal? Yes. Like what? Riba, usually, for example. It's a riba, it's a haram. They give different title, different name. They said what? Al-fa'idah. Profit. Huh? Al-fa'idah. Yeah, it's a riba. No, 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 it's a different name. Al-khamr. It's al-kuhul. It's a haram. No, they give different name. They said the spiritual mashroob. Mashroobat al-ruhiyya. Mashroobat al-ruhiyya. La hawla qadha. It's a khamr, ya am. No, treating their parents in very bad way because too many excuses. فسبحانallah, even zina, they give different title for zina too. نكاح المتعة, سبحانallah, different types of invalid نكاح, and they said it's halal, brother. Who said that? The Mufti. What kind of Mufti? استباحة المحرمات. The haram. Somehow they change the name and the title and they put it in different way and they halal ya ammi, dude, yes, it's okay. It's not okay. This is fitan. These are the too many fitans. That's why our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in that hadith and the dua, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-hawri ba'd al-kawri. What's it mean? He said, oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from what? Al-hawri. What is al-hawr? From hanky-panky, sneaky. Yeah, somebody sneaky, somebody sneaking, going right and left like this. It's not in the straight way. What is al-kawr? Al-kawr, if you have turban, imama, and if you kawarha, kawr in Arabic, you fix it, became, mashallah, very tight and good in your head. Amama, turban. And somehow, somebody come and break it, and cut it, and throw it away. This is what Rasulullah said. Let me give you the explanation of the scholars of this dua. Again, the dua said, Allahumma inni, O Allah, inni a'udhu bika. I seek refuge with you from what? Al-hawri after al-kawr. What is al-hawr? The scholar said, فساد الأمور بعد استقامتها. After being in a straight path, mashallah, doing good, your affairs, your task, everything in your life being corrupted again. And somebody, after he being obedient to Allah, he came back to الكفر and the disobedience, and he became disobedient to Allah, and he makes sins. The meaning also, الرجوع من الجماعة. You're leaving your group, your jama'ah, your congregation, and you became alone and said, I don't want to deal with anybody. You feel you are alone like that. This is not right. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran, if you read verse number 33 in chapter of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah Azza wa Jal Almighty said, you must, there is no choice, obey Allah and His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If I will not do, what is the problem? The problem is Allah will not accept my good deeds. Yes. Allah said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول ولا تبطلوا أعمالكم. O you who have believed, obey Allah and obey His Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and do not invalidate your good deeds by disbelief. Do not invalidate your good deeds by disbelief. ولا تبطلوا أعمالكم. Means, if I pray in Ramadan, I fast, I make all good deeds as you know, Alhamdulillah. After Ramadan, I turn my back to Allah and His Messenger. I'm not obeying anymore. Means Allah will not accept from me the month of Ramadan. I did invalidate my good deeds. This is what I said. Rasulullah, in his life, in his way to Allah Azza wa Jal, he used to ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make his heart firm in the way of Islam, steadfast. How? He said the hadith, our hearts between two fingers of the fingers of Allah Azza wa Jal. He can change it anytime. The meaning of al-qalb in Arabic, the word al-qalb, the definition of our word, al-qalb, al-qalb means your heart. Al-qalb min al-taqallub, changing all the time. Like what? Like if you have a feather and you hang that feather in a tree in the desert in very windy day. Imagine that feather again, how gonna move and turn into many times. Our heart like that. Today you're a mu'min. You're coming to the masjid. Mashallah, you're doing very well. Suddenly your heart change. That's why Rasulullah used to make this dua. Allahumma, oh Allah, ya muqallib al-qulub, you are the one who changed the hearts. Thabbit qalbi ala deenik, make my heart firm, steadfast in your deen. This is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying. One time, because of this fitan and evil and bad stuff, one day he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Zainab bint Jahsh, his wife, she narrated that hadith. Rasulullah came to us while he was very mad. And when he became mad, you see the redness of his face. His face turned red because of his anger. He said, وَيْلٌ لِلْعَرَبِ مِنْ شَرٍ قَدْ اِقْتَرَبِ وَوْ تُو عَرَبِ. Arab people. Why, Rasulullah, from that evil which is coming soon to them. مِنْ شَرٍ, from the evil is coming soon to them. مِنْ شَرٍ قَدْ اِقْتَرَبِ. Why, Rasulullah, said, لَقَدْ فُتَحَ الْيَوْمَ مِنْ رَدْمِ مَأْجُوجُ وَمَأْجُوجُ. Today the wall of Gog and Magog, it will be open like this. It's opening like this. And Gog and Magog, already they're coming. Surat al-Anbiya, Surat al-Kahf, read. These two tribes, Gog and Magog, they call it يأجوج ومأجوج. Yeah. صلى الله عليه وسلم said, why رسول الله? He said, because of the haram, فواحش, evil acts of people, disobedient to Allah, doing all kind of haram. Even the man, he will be a mu'min in the morning. In the end of the day, he will turn into al-kufr, disbelief. In the morning, he's mu'min. In the end of the day, he's kafir. He will be in disbelief. Why? He said, يَبِعْ دِينَهُ بِعَرْضٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. That kind of person, he will withdraw. He will withdraw his deen with little of this dunya. Look how people will do. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one he's holding his deen, he's stucking with his deen, like somebody during the time carrying like burning stone in his hand. Stone full of fire in his hand. Burn. That's not easy. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructing us, he said, you see people after they came to the masjid, they pray, they are not coming to the masjid anymore. They have khusuma, mushahana, fighting with their brothers all the time. Shayateen, they are working. After he used to make good deeds, he stopped making good deeds anymore. But he's doing bad deeds. And you see that sister, after she wear the hijab and the cover, and she was very proud of it. Now she throwing her hijab away from her. This is not right. That's why Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, brothers, sisters, try to follow your deen as much as you can. He said, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ. As much as you can, fear Allah Azza wa Jal. If Allah give you hidayah, guidance, iman, taqwa, fear of Him, mashallah, you're doing your salah in jama'ah. You have full of, your face full of nur, light. Your iman, your heart full of iman and faith. And you feel, because you are in the way of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's support with you. The mercy of Allah, you are into His mercy. He's showering you with His mercy, tranquility, rahmah, because of your good deeds. You feel that. And only the mu'min, he will feel that. Imagine somebody has this gift from Allah, and suddenly he turned his back to Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Al-A'raf, verse 176, He's giving example about that person. He said, فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ الْكَلْبِ إِن تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَثْ أَوْ تَتْرُكُهُ يَلْهَثْ. ذلك مثل الذين كذبوا بآياتنا فقصص القصص لعلهم يتفكرون. The example of that person, he is like a dog. He is like what? A dog. If you drive him away, he lolls his tongue out. And if you leave him alone, he lolls his tongue out. Meaning. If you give him tazkira, maw'iza, he will never listen to you. And if you leave him alone, he will never listen to you. If you give him knowledge, same for him if you did not. If you bring him to the masjid and he has iman and the taqwa Allah, same as if you did not give him anything. While he's standing or sitting, he lolls his tongue out. If you drive him away, he lolls his tongue out. Both ways, he's bad. He's not listening. He will never be guided. He's like a dog, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Why? Because he followed his desires. Allah said, if we will, we'll put him in high position because of this knowledge and this our signs we give it to him. But he stuck in the dirt, in the mud, because he followed his desires, shahwat, and he stopped obeying Allah, and he is like a dog. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you know, dear brothers, sisters, He created us for a mission, for ghaya, for hadaf, purpose. What? To worship Him alone. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونِ لِيَعْبُدُونِ. Allah said that. To worship Allah Almighty alone. فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ فِي الْيُسْرِ وَفِي الْعُسْرِ. You worship Allah alone during your ease time and during your difficult time. During, while you're struggling and striving, while you are good, worship Allah. While you're happy, while you're sad. Al-mu'min, al-muslim, al-sadiq, huwa al-mustaqim ala ta'atillah. The real mu'min, the one all the time he's trying to put himself in the straight path, in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever happened around you, the bala, the fitna, so strong, you are a mu'min. Like what? If you get a piece of gold and you put it thousands of years in the mud in the bottom of the ocean, or in the sand in the bottom of the ocean, after thousands of years, is there any change going to happen to this piece of gold? Of course not, at all. Because it's gold, it's not iron. The mu'min is like that. Whatever happening around you, people dying, people killing each other, people away from Allah, people insulting each other, people they are following the shaitan, you are a mu'min. I don't care. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, look at this, إِنَّ مِنْ وَرَائِكُمْ أَيَّامَ الصَّبْرِ الْمُسْتَمْسِكُ فِيهِنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِمَا أَنْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرَ خَمْسِينَ قَالُوا يَا نَبِيَ اللَّهِ مِنَّا أَوْ مِنْهُمْ قَالَ بَلْ مِنْكُمْ. Look at this hadith. He said, إِنَّ مِنْ وَرَائِكُمْ After you, Rasulullah was talking to the Sahab, after you, the days of patience. The days of patience. During these days, any one of us will follow his deen, he will be rewarded as 50 of the Sahaba. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, 50 of them or us? Said, no, 50 of you, of the Sahaba. Al-Mutamassik, Mutamassik, you hold in your deen. Hold up in your deen. You're going to be rewarded like 50 of the Sahaba. The days of patience, Rasulullah said in the Hadith. Days of patience means what? Days of patience means what? Days of fitna. During this time of fitna, if you stuck with your deen, you will be rewarded as if 50 of the Sahaba of Rasulullah. Rasulullah used to make dua, saying, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min wa'atha'i safar wa ka'abat al-munqalab wal-hawr ba'd al-kawr wa da'wat al-mazlum وسوء المنظر في الأهل والمال. He used to ask Allah, Rasulullah, saying, Oh Allah, when I travel, make it easy for me. The hardship of the traveling, make it easy for me. Oh Allah, when I die, I don't want to die in a very bad way. Oh Allah, I don't want to leave my deen, al-hawr ba'd al-kawr. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you also from the dua of somebody being oppressed. Da'wat al-mazloom. Da'wat al-mazloom. Also, oh Allah, protect my family and my wealth and my money. وسوء المنظر في الأهل والمال. The real success, dear brothers and sisters, if Allah will save you from this fitan, trials and afflictions and temptation. The real success when you get out of this dunya and you turn your face to Jannah. Jannah, arda as-samawat al-ard. Jannah of Allah, Azza wa Jal. Allah said, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. وَمَا الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. If you will be dragged from the hellfire little away and you will be in Jannah, subhanallah, this is the ultimate success, dunya and the akhirah. Real winning. The ultimate success, not to have money, position, whatever in this dunya, people dying and they leave everything. The ultimate success, when you have something in Arabic, it's called al-falah, not al-najah. Najah means success, but al-falah in Arabic means success, dunya and the akhirah both. Al-najah means just the dunya. You have money, kids, education, you're a successful person. business. This is in dunya. It's called najah, najah. But the word falah is different. That's why Allah uses it in the Quran. فَأُولَيْكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. In the Azan, what we say, حَيَّ عَلَى النَّجَاحِ or حَيَّ عَلَى الْفَلَاحِ. حَيَّ عَلَى الْفَلَاحِ. وَزْمِنْ الْفَلَاحِ بَا فَلَاح dunya and the akhirah. You'll be successful in this dunya and the akhirah. Both is called falah. But the dunya is just the dunya and najah. You're najah. Yeah, you have some money, whatever Allah gave it to you, it's okay. What we have to do to be survive from al-mihan, al-fitan, from these trials or afflictions or temptations or whatever. First of all, tawbah. Always repent to Allah. Ask Allah for His forgiveness. Number two, Salat al-Jama'ah. I see too many people, they stop coming to the masjid after Ramadan. Salat al-Jama'ah, very important. Three, Quran. Recite the Quran. Listen to the Quran. The minimum every day, one juz. While you're driving, you have that smartphone, just put YouTube and listen to the Quran in your car. Everything is easy now. Instead of listening to song or whatever haram, no, build up your hasanat, make hasanat, good deeds, and listen to the kalam Allah, Al Quran Al Kareem. Zikr, especially after Salat Al Fajr and before Maghrib, zikr. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu dhkuru Allah dhikran kathir. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much as you can. Also, dua. Dua is your silah, your weapon. If you have weapon in your hand, this is your dua. Any kind of good deeds, it will be good, inshallah. But also very important, al-bu'd an al-haram. Brother Ahmed, Kabir Akbar, he was asking me after salah, after Maghrib now. One of his friends from somewhere in Europe, asked him, how can I know I am very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How can I know I am very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I need short answer. He said, I'm not a scholar, but give me short answer. I told him, if you make the fara'id and you are away from the haram, this is the minimum with your relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal. If you make the fariida, and you abstain from the haram, you are in a good way. This is, you are very near to Allah, inshallah. And this is the minimum. And you have to do your this ibadat until you die. وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَتَيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. And ask Allah to make you firm.